So the monastery of Marmoutier, founded by Saint Martin circa 370, is built partly in the Loire Valley and partly in the plateau of Rougemont. According to Sulpice Severus, Saint Martin's biographer, and other early texts such as Gregory of Tours works, the cliff is occupied from the beginning of the monastic community, which excavated caves to live in them. It has been used throughout the history of the Abbey as evidenced by extensive underground quarries, often reused for wine production. The western terraces of the Abbey, near the gate of Saint Radegonde, are occupied by caves and tombs from the beginning of the early Middle Ages. From the 11th century, earthworks and various constructions tend to monumentalize this space, which was the main entrance of the monastery. This area is characterized by a hillside layout and a semi-troglodytic architecture that have strongly influenced the planning and the shape of the building. The Priory of the Seven Sleepers, of which we have an inventory dating from the first half of the 16th century, occupies the space between the west wall and the bell tower. The wall complex is spread over three main levels. The first terrace is occupied mainly by the Romanesque chapel Notre-Dame des Sept Dormants, which replaced a small early medieval oratory. From the chapel, we reach various cavities further west, including the so-called St. Patrick Caves. The second terrace is probably a larger garden opening on the cave St. Leobard. To the west, the highest terraces correspond to the prior's house, troglodyte dependencies, and various pieces of land such as garden and vineyards. The study of this area, undertaken between 2013 and 2018, required archaeological investigation adapted to the semi-troglodytic character of the site on the one hand and the very poor conservation of the remains on the other hand. Among the highlights, we can mention in 1747 the collapse of part of the hill, which destroyed a large part of the chapel, whose ruin will finally be demolished in 1786. And also in the 19th century, earthworks, excavation and restoration of the cave operated by the Sisters of the Sacred Heart of Jesus were certainly responsible for the demolition of what was left of the stratification of the site. So only a very small portion of the site is currently preserved, mainly in the form of old ducts through the rock, which were cut from an unknown level, some masonry more or less preserved, and a few shreds of archaeological layers still in place. The history and layout of the site is also documented by some textual and iconographic evidence, including traveling reports dating back for the oldest to the 16th century. These sources are of various quality and sometimes contradictory, which make difficult their critical analysis and their confrontation with archaeological remains. Despite the partial nature of the data, we managed to reconstruct the organization and evolution of the western terraces from the first occupation at the beginning of the early Middle Ages until their restoration in the 19th century. This work is based on a spatial analysis of the remains, some stylistic and radiocarbon dating, as well as a comparative example, which make it possible to propose at first hypothetical reconstruction in two dimensions. The 3D modeling of the terraces, initiated last July, make it possible to specify, confirm, or revise this hypothesis and to have a better understanding of the chapel. A large part of the rock disappeared, obviously because of its digging over time, but also because of various collapses. So, the first step of the work was to reconstruct the original feature and profile of the hill based on current observation points, but also from archival and material data. We know, for example, that some rock tombs were still covered by the rock until the second half of the 19th century. rather than a step cliff along the entire length of the hill, we can reconstruct an alternation of profiles and varied slopes. From west to east, we restore a peak, a trug or a north-south depression, a possible stagging of ledges or terraces more or less marked, and finally a vertical advance of the rock at the foot of which a gentle slope allows to descend into the valley. The excavation reveals the presence of two groups of tombs dug through the rock, intersected by the first masonry attributed to the early Middle Ages chapel. Their location and altitude in relation to the later remains and the proposed restitution of the hill line suggest that this small funerary complex was underground. About 10 meters to the west, some rock projection and stratified levels testify to the presence of troglodytes of irregular planes. The contemporaneity with the burial is uncertain, and the early datation of this cavity is among other things deduced from the many enlargements that will occur after. Probably in the 7th century, according to the radiocarbon dating of a tomb associated with this phase, the existing troglodytes were turned into a small underground oratory with the addition of an apse built in petit appareil. It may be the crypta dedicated to Notre Dame mentioned in a charter in the mid-9th century. The building is then in a state of disrepair, and its restoration is announced by the Comte Vivien. An altar based on a platform faced twin graves dug into the rock. Graves with a peripheral projection that undoubtedly allows for a monolithic cover. Other graves are then dug both inside and outside the chapel. The last phase prior to the Romanesque chapel deals with the enlargement of the oratory mentioned in the mid-9th century. This is evidenced by the very disturbed remains of an apse, which is circular inside but flat outside, built with limestone block, which was abutting to the rock to the north and was enlightened by an axial bay to the east. A Carolingian dating is likely. The troglodyte parts are also enlarged. To the west, the cavities are certainly widened and turned into one single space. A projection of the rock suggests that the partition exists with the part of the oratory containing the tomb. To the east, a north-south gallery is dug, ending with two alcoves with a niche. The masonry portion of the oratory is also enlarged to the east, outside the apparent rocky ground, which would imply the presence of a rump roof covered with tile or slate. New graves are also installed inside and outside the oratory. One of them, at the foot of the eastern masonry, could be dated from the 10th century. The cult of the Seven Sleepers, des Sept Dormants, develops from the 12th century onwards at Marmoutier. The construction of a new chapel dedicated to Notre-Dame des Sept Dormants is undoubtedly the consequence of it. The building is Romanesque and much larger than the pre-existing oratory, as evidenced by the few remains preserved, as well as textual and iconographic records. In the current state of the investigation, we can reconstruct a chapel partly dug through the rock, partly built in stones, which occupied the wall of the first terrace, but is separated from the hillside on the second terrace. Its overall dimensions are 22.70 meters long and 9.60 meters wide for a wall height of about 8 meters. The Romanesque roof with a 45 slope should be culminated at about 13 meters. Inside the chapel, two spaces are distinguished, several authors evoke two different chapels. To the east is an underground, underground chapel which corresponds more or less to the oratory of the early Middle Ages truncated. So the oratory truncated by its bedside apse. To the west, a vault chapel in masonry whose internal dimensions are given in the report of the collapse of the hill in 1747, namely 40.60 meters long and 7.60 meters wide. To the north, a gallery excavated through the rock, 2.30 meters wide, is separated from the main nave by an arcade wall. To the west, a north-south wall divided in the middle by a large doorway opens onto a semi-subterranean space which with uncertain function. The covering of the chapel could be a semicircular barrel vault or a vault ogee, and in both cases, the restitution of the inside height will be around 7.50 meters. The initial ornamentation of the chapels seems to have been fairly simple, consisting only on ropes, red-sided painted joints, des faux joints rouges. Sorry for my English. Some modifications occur in the Western Chapel, probably during the 13th, 14th centuries. A new decor of fine red-sided joints is executed. Glass ground tiles are installed, as evidenced by a slight scrap of the rock and the shreds of mortar installation, and also corbels, one of which is still in place in the northwest corner of the main nave, could support a gallery against the west wall. Many transformations, which chronology remains difficult to apprehend, take place between the 15th and 18th centuries. They are mentioned in the History of Marmoutier by Dom Martin and in the report of the excavation executed by the Sister of the Sacred Heart. The main transformation carried out consists in the opening of a corridor between the Arcade Gallery and the Early Middle Age Sanctuary, just here. The repair of one of the arcade of the gallery, just here too, and one or more ornamental campaigns. It is also during this period that the space located at the second level of the terrace, between the chapel and the hill, is covered with a framework in shade, as evidenced by holes of beams and traces of mortar on the west wall of the bell tower. It is the green space you have here. And the last changes of the site are made by the Sister of the Sacred Heart. In the second half of the 19th century. So excavation and the building of a new neo-romanesque chapel. C'était la fin.